This is an example of a gamma scan of a packed tower where the results indicated that fouling was present. Now, because fouling was suspected, a single scan of the tower was performed rather than a full grid scan. As such, a radioactive source was placed on one side of the tower, radiation detector was placed on the opposite side, and radiation was transmitted and then detected through a single scan path of the tower. The gamma scan started at the top tangent line, and the radioactive source and detector were lowered simultaneously down the tower through each of the three packed beds. This produced a density profile, or a gamma scan profile, that's reproduced on the left. Low density on the right-hand side of the plot, with increases in density towards the left. So ideally, each of these packed sections should show consistent density readings from top to bottom. As can be seen here, there's higher density at the top, decreasing density towards the bottom. In addition to that, the actual relative density readings are much higher than what would be expected for a column of this diameter and with this type of packing. So the first gamma scan essentially revealed that fouling was present through each of the three packed sections. Based on the results of the scan that showed fouling to be present in all three of the packed sections of the tower, plant personnel decided to perform a column wash with the hopes of removing any solids buildup in the packed sections. A second gamma scan was requested in order to assess the effectiveness of that wash. The scan was done in the exact same manner as the first scan, so that the results could be directly comparable. In this case, a slight decrease in density was noticed for the top distributor, as well as the top 2 or 3 feet of the top packed bed. However, the remainder of the tower showed increases in density. Thus, this indicated that the column wash was ineffective. And unfortunately, plant personnel were required to enter the tower and replace the packing. After the packing sections of the tower were replaced, a baseline scan was requested in order to help monitor any fouling that may occur in the future. The baseline scan is shown here in green, and it shows much more consistent density readings from top to bottom. It provides an overall clean profile of the tower. Now, with the benefit of the baseline scan moving forward, subtle changes in density can be detected, indicating even the slightest initiation of fouling, and thus plant personnel can plan accordingly. To summarize the results, the first gamma scan of the tower showed that fouling was present. The second gamma scan of the tower showed that a wash was unsuccessful. And finally, the third gamma scan, a baseline scan, provided a clean profile of the tower for future troubleshooting. Thank you for your interest.